when you're working with hair, it's useful to know what you're actually working with. The first thing we need to look at is the visible part of the hair, which is the hair shaft itself. The hair shaft extends up from the scalp and is made of three parts: the cuticle, the cortex, and in some cases, the medulla. The outermost layer of the hair is known as the cuticle, and that acts as a protective shield for the inner layers. It's translucent and consists of overlapping scale-like cells that kind of resemble roof tiles. The cuticle protects the hair from damage such as heat, UV rays, chemical treatments, hair bands, overbrushing. It can become damaged, but that's the first layer of the hair that can be damaged. Moving inward from there, we encounter the cortex. This is the thickest layer of the hair shaft. This region is responsible for the hair's strength, elasticity, and color. It contains long chains of keratin proteins. Keratin protein you may have seen before, because this is the same thing that your fingernails and toenails are made out of. The amount of arrangement of these proteins determine the hair's strength and texture. When talking about the cortex there, I did mention elasticity. Now, hair can stretch up to 30% of its original length and come back to its original length. That is a sign of healthy hair. Hair that stretches and doesn't spring back to its original length is probably damaged. It's overcolored, or it's had too many processes, chemical processes. Perhaps it's been straightened too many times with hot tongs, but that's damaged hair. Good elasticity in hair is important when you're cutting hair, because if you put tension on it by pulling it with your fingers, you need to know what's going to happen when you let go of it. Is it going to go back to where it went? Or if it is damaged, are you going to put tension under it and it won't return to its original state? So you need to understand the level of elasticity, and the cortex is very important for that. The third layer in some hair types is the central core, called the medulla. The medulla is mostly present in thick hair and can be completely absent in fine hairs. We don't need to worry too much about the medulla. The exact function of it remains a topic of scientific debate, and it's not entirely necessary for us. To understand the complete structure, we need to explore what lies beneath the skin's surface, the hair follicle. The hair follicle is a tiny tunnel-like structure that surrounds the hair root, and that takes me to the root. At the base of the hair follicle lies the hair bulb. This is where the cells actively divide, pushing older cells upward, forming the hair shaft. It also contains the dermal papilla, which supplies nutrients and blood to the growing hair. Also present and next to the hair follicle, you can find the sebaceous gland that produces sebum. Now, this is very important. It's a natural oil that moisturizes the scalp and hair and gives it shine and, importantly, protection. When you're consulting with your clients, it's going to be very helpful for you if you understand sebaceous oil, because sebaceous oil affects the moisture of the hair. Oily hair, dry scalp, oily scalp, dandruff, all these problems can be caused by an imbalance in the sebaceous oil that's produced. And there's going to be a separate lesson just on that later on. Lastly, the hair follicle is connected to the erector pili muscle, which contracts when we're cold or experiencing strong emotions, which is what gives you goosebumps and causes the hair to stand on end. The structure of hair is a remarkable combination of complex layers and structures that gives us our unique hair types and characteristics. From the cuticle's protection to the cortex's strength and the medulla's presence in some hair types, our hair is a truly incredible feature of our bodies. It's our job to care for the hair of other people. It's not only a symbol of their looks, but also an essential part of their identity. So having an understanding of what we're actually working with is really important on day one of barbering.